Hi, I'm Paul Pugliese with the University of Georgia Cooperative Extension. Today we're in Cartersville, Georgia at a very busy intersection. There's a lot of noise in the background, but I had to bring you here to see a great example of a really bad problem. If you grow roses in Georgia, you need to be aware of a common problem known as rose rosette virus. This is actually an old virus that's been around since the 1940s, but really wasn't actually identified as a common problem until around 2011 is when pathologists actually confirmed that this was an issue. It's now showing up in rose bushes in just about every commercial landscape planting and in backyards throughout metro Atlanta and just about anywhere in the state of Georgia. I see it all the time everywhere I go. And so this is an example of a planting of knockout roses, and other rose species are susceptible to this disease as well. But this particular variety actually is one that is highly susceptible, and we're seeing it more and more common in this variety because it's planted so often around metro Atlanta and throughout Georgia. It's a very popular rose variety, and we're seeing this disease now. This particular disease, again, is a virus. It's not a fungus disease. It's a virus that infects the plant. It can actually be moved by a couple of different ways. One, there's actually a tiny little mite called an aerophoid mite that can actually pick up the sap on these branches and carry the virus and infect from, you know, branch to branch or leaf to leaf. It can also move by pruning tools. So if you have a landscaper or somebody that does any pruning or maintenance on your roses in your landscape, if their tools are infected or contaminated with the virus, they can actually move that virus from landscape site to landscape site. What you need to watch out for as the symptoms of this disease, you'll get a lot of new succulent growth that has a really dark reddish color sometimes in the early springtime. You'll get a lot of thorns, excessive thorniness. Then you'll get some branch dieback associated with this. You'll get some leaf curling and leaf twisting. Really, really weird, unusual symptoms associated with rose rosette virus. If you have it, it's usually pretty obvious by the time the plant is fully infected at that point. Unfortunately, there is no cure for this disease. So if you have roses that are infected with this virus, you have to destroy them. You either have to bag them up, haul them away, or burn them is actually the recommendation. If you leave them out there, there's a good chance that this virus will move to other roses in your landscape. It takes about 2 or 3 years for the virus to get bad enough in the plant before it will probably die. And there are no resistant rose varieties out there that you can use as a substitute, unfortunately. The mites actually are another issue that we have to worry about. Some people ask, well, can we treat for the mites? Yes, you could spray for the mites, but realize that these mites are really, really hard to control. They're very, very tiny. You almost need a microscope to see them. And so control is really not the best option for managing this virus. Even though they do carry the virus, those mites can actually be blown by the wind. They don't really fly, but they can blow in the wind and move from plant to plant and go several feet down the road pretty quickly. All right, so one of the best ways to manage this disease is to make sure you clean your tools. And you got to disinfect those tools with either a bleach solution, a Lysol disinfectant, or even rubbing alcohol. So these are all good options for disinfecting your tools. And you can mix it up into a spray bottle solution, and you'll actually spray down those tools. And you'll actually want to leave that or let it soak for about 10 seconds. And that'll make sure that you clean that tool really good and get the virus off. And after about 10 seconds, you can wipe them dry. I would caution you that if you use a bleach solution, that it can rust your tools. So when you're done at the end of the day, if you use bleach especially, you'll want to wash them off really good, apply a little bit of a lubricant, and then oil them really good for storage, and then they're good to go for the next day. If you have a lot of roses that you need to disinfect your tools with, it's a good idea to stop and disinfect at least between each rose plant. But if you have a lot of plants, it may be time consuming to have to stop and disinfect your tools all the time. So one way to do that is to mix up a solution into a bucket and have several pairs of pruning tools soaking in that bucket. That way you'll have one ready to go for each plant that you go to. Again, with these plants that are behind me, the recommendation would be to pull those plants out, get them out completely. But if you have any plants that you're just not too sure about or they might be infected, and you just want to be extra cautious, again, take the time to disinfect those pruning tools and insist that your landscaper do the same thing. If you have a landscaper or professional that comes out and prunes your roses in the landscape, they need to take the time to do this as well. So if you have any additional questions, feel free to call your local county extension office or go to our website at ugaextension.com, and be sure to follow us on the Georgia Farm Monitor.